So the question comes up a lot, how do harmonic filters work? Passive harmonic filters, and how do you apply them on a power system as a system approach to eliminate or minimize harmonic currents? What is a passive filter? Let's start there. The basic components of a passive filter are a reactor and a capacitor connected in series on the power system and attached to some point on your power system, like a bus or your main switchboard or maybe switchgear or even inside a motor control center. So how does a harmonic filter work? Let's take a look at this picture. So as we're looking at this, each drive, for example, might produce a certain amount of harmonic current. In this case, we're saying 12 amps of fifth harmonic current coming out of each drive. Remember, constant current source. So that 36 amps of current comes up to the bus and will now divide. And if I have a harmonic filter, that harmonic filter becomes a lower impedance than perhaps the source. And in this case, some of the current will go back to the source. Some of the current might go to a generator if I had a parallel generator in the system. But some of it will flow to the filter. What a lot of people think is that all the harmonic current will go to the filter, and the other thing they think is that the harmonics go to ground. But in fact, they don't go to ground. They flow out on phase A, and they flow back on B and C. They flow out on B, and they flow back on A and C. They flow out on C, and they flow back on A and B. And the thing that's different, again, is it's different than a surge protector that you want the current to go to ground. In this case, the harmonics have to go out on the system and come back to the load. So when we do this and we reduce the harmonic current, that filter will then basically improve the bus voltage because the THD on the bus is going to be improved because I'm reducing the current flowing through my impedance. And again, it all comes back to the impedance. So now if I take a look at a switched harmonic filter that has multiple stages, and in this case we have five different stages for this single tuned filter. What do I mean by single tuned? I mean it's going to be tuned close to the fifth harmonic. And why do I pick the fifth harmonic? I want to take the fifth harmonic because that's the harmonic that's closest, or the lowest available harmonic that's the most significant, and I want to reduce that on my power system. So in this case we have five stages and we're going to switch them in, and you can see this graphic basically indicates a sort of a frequency response to the filter. So it has a very low impedance based on the tuning point, and it has a high impedance just below that. That's what we call the parallel resonant point. Controlling that parallel resonant point and controlling the tuning point are really what makes a harmonic filter design good or bad. And so, you know, there's a whole lot of detail that goes into that. But this is how filters work. We switch in the different stages in different steps of power factor correction, and as we add those stages, we end up with more and more harmonic filtering capability. Now, if I have a double tuned filter, for example, I might have a fifth harmonic and a seventh harmonic filter because I'm trying to correct or minimize or reduce the voltage distortion associated with those harmonics on my system. So I want to attract those harmonics into my filter. So I put a fifth and a seventh on, and you can see that they also have their own tuning points or low impedance points at the given frequencies that we select. And this graphic also shows that it could work on a normal utility source and the generator source as well. So if you're thinking about creating harmonic filters, there's a few tricks that you have to understand, and I wouldn't suggest, you know, just basically taking a reactor and a capacitor and creating your own without a little bit of knowledge in this area. First of all, you want to create a computer simulation to make sure that your design is going to be robust enough to decide, you know, if it's going to work. And when we decide, obviously we have to decide where we're going to put it. We're going to select low or medium voltage on the power system to decide where that filter is going to have the most effect and create the least problems. But what a lot of people don't realize is when you go to design a harmonic filter, you start with power factor correction first. Power factor correction is the primary reason why we put filters on. And you might say, but I thought they're called harmonic filters. Well, they are, but in fact, most of the time you put a filter in, it's primarily for power factor correction first, and it has the added benefit of controlling harmonics, not allowing resonance to happen, and perhaps even attracting some of the currents from the system to make the harmonic voltage distortion better by attracting the harmonic currents. And then you have to decide if it's going to be fixed or switched, and that really has to do with, do I have a fixed load or a variable load? Since we're applying these as power factor correction, if I have a variable load and I have a very light load, I might have a whole bunch of harmonic filter capacity, meaning power factor correction capacity, and I might raise my voltage. So I have to be careful that I don't overdo it, which is why a lot of times we use switched filters, which again adds a little bit to the cost, but can be a benefit. The tuning point is also important. And again, as you get into this, you'll realize some people tune them to 4.2. Most of the time, that's really just to avoid resonance. But you still want the power factor benefit. You want to control resonance. 4.7 or 4.8 is usually considered a fifth harmonic filter. We off-tune them for a couple reasons that we'll talk about in other FAQs. But most of the time, we want to keep it right below the harmonic of interest that we're trying to filter out on the system. A multi-tune filter where we're trying to attract multiple different things, fifth and seventh, for example, we always pick the lowest harmonic order that we have on the system. For 480-volt systems, it's going to be fifth harmonic typically. For 12208-volt systems, it's going to be the third harmonic. So you might need a third and fifth. Or in the case of 480, you might need a fifth and a seventh. And then finally, you have to consider what's your present load and what's your future load going to be, because passive harmonic filters are designed for a specific load, and you have to understand that what's going to happen if I overload that filter, or like I mentioned earlier, underload that filter and allow the loads to allow the voltage to creep up. So passive harmonic filters work well for a system approach, but they do require simulation and an understanding of how they're going to be applied on the power system.